most artists, you have to be in tune with everything. Like, I love fashion, I love interior design, I love music, I love just being outside. And I think that was one of the things I loved about LA. There's so much visually going on just when you walk out on the street, even if it's something dirty, something beautiful. I spend a lot of time on Pinterest and Tumblr, but I really like just experiencing things and looking at other forms of art, and that inspires me.
Hi, I'm Ciara Bird, and I'm the creative director and co-founder of Four Magazine.
We felt like there was a void in the Charlotte area, and that there was enough going on in LA that it wouldn't really be able to find its place. But in Charlotte, a magazine like ours would appeal to a wider audience, and that's really what we wanted. We wanted a creative outlet for local creatives to highlight different things that are going on, all the beautiful homes, all the different art that really isn't captured in any of the other magazines based in Charlotte. My dad is a musician and my mom's an interior designer, and my sister's an artist and a photographer, so kind of everyone in my family was always doing something. There was always something going on. So since my mom is an interior designer, I grew up seeing her choosing accessories, picking out paint colors, and when we lived in Georgia, she was always designing like the show homes when they would do the like parade of homes, those big events. It always was exciting to me to go to the fabric store, and I would always like take all of the little swatches, and it actually influenced me more in my choice to be a fashion designer, which is what I wanted to do for a long time, more than my graphic design work. But now that I'm decorating my own home and choosing things, we have very, very different styles, but we work well together. We talk about things together very well, and I had no choice but to be creative with my parents.
How do you define your design aesthetic?
That's such a hard question. I think that it's like bohemian California luxe, because I like if Kelly Wurstler mixed with Rachel Zoe. Mm-hmm. I love the black and white, but then I also love vibrant colors, but I like it to be very clean but also whimsical. So I was actually planning and ready to go to MICA in Baltimore, because I was still planning to major in fine art. And at the last minute, all of my teachers were like, if you want to be in magazines versus studying fashion art, you should study graphic design. Mm-hmm. So FIDM was sort of in the back of my mind when I wanted to be a fashion designer. And then I went to Portfolio Day and I met all the different art colleges. And the guy at the FIDM table was like, you need to come here. I actually brought this book, well, one similar to it, and he was like, you need to study visual communications, but I was like, no, I want to do magazines, so I ended up in graphic design. They obviously teach us how to use all of the creative programs, all of the Adobe programs, but they also teach us typography, publication design, we learn photo editing, but they teach us how to be clever and use wit and really like think about the execution of what we're designing and the reason behind it, and it needs to make sense. It's not just choosing a pretty font and putting it together. It annoys me personally that so many people these days are calling themselves graphic designers, because it takes away from my skill, because people automatically assume that they can get something done for much less, and it's going to take me probably less time than that person that you hire, but I went to school for this. This is what I do. I know what I'm talking about. And it's more than just knowing how to use Photoshop and Illustrator, and I can choose a font and two colors that work. There's so much more to it than that.
When did you know that you wanted to do magazines?
I have always loved books and magazines, and just I need to have stuff. Even though I have an iPad, you see I have a million books, because I like to keep things. And I was always cutting out pictures and collages, and it always fascinated me, the idea to have my work printed out on something that people would get to have. So even though I liked fashion, it was always something in the back of my mind. Mm-hmm. Right after I graduated, I actually went back to Charlotte, and it was pretty tough finding where I would fit in because my design style is very different from what people in Charlotte want. Mm-hmm. I was very, very lucky to land a really, really good internship with a local agency, and it was a paid internship, and so basically it was my 9-to-5, and I didn't do much freelance at that time. And then towards the end of it, when I started getting antsy and wanted to move back to California, I started picking up freelance, and that's why I moved back there, where I was able to do more freelance projects, which turned into multiple projects, and then I came back to Charlotte.
Let's talk about For Magazine. When did you start it? I know you've been back in Charlotte for how long now?
About a year.
Okay. So you've started this in a year. It's such a beautiful, high quality magazine. What made you decide to do a magazine here in Charlotte?
Well, I actually started thinking about it when I was still in California. And so it was probably about a 3-month period before I started thinking about it. And I moved back and we actually made it happen. But I was just playing around with the idea of if I had a magazine, the things that I would want to do, because I was kind of frustrated with the working for a company and you have to do what they want you to do, and I needed a project that I could just be free and do the things that I wanted to do and talk about what I wanted to talk about. So I reconnected with my partner, Nicole Kamak, who I worked with on a previous publication, and we just started bouncing ideas around, and I let her know I was moving back, and then that's kind of how it all started and where it began. Well, me and Nicole have a wonderful dynamic. Like we really are like yin and yang to each other. The way I design is the way she writes, and it's just a perfect matchup. But it's just me and her. We did a very under the radar marketing. We just printed flyers that said there's a new magazine coming and we want contributors, and I walked around everywhere in Charlotte, put it in every boutique, every art gallery, and just really talked to people, told them what I was doing. And it was a little frustrating because about half of the people were like, yeah, that's really cool. And then half of the people were like, they didn't really understand the quality that I was trying to put out. Because I'm sure that everybody, when they start a new project, they're like, this is gonna be super high end and super slick, and we're using this kind of paper. So they were just like, okay. But so yeah, when we put it out there, it was really like, this is what we're trying to do, and everybody got it at that point. Mm-hmm. We knew that we had to do something different to separate it from everything else in Charlotte, first of all. And as a designer, paper is everything to me. Working at Flaunt, they would use like multiple papers, and that really like elevated my taste level when it came to magazines. And I wanted something that felt like a coffee table book, something you would want to keep and put out, and it's not going to come out all the time. It's something you want to hold on to. So we knew that it had to be high quality, and we weren't going to sacrifice that for anything else. Well, the way we work is basically everyone who is involved with the magazine outside of Nicole and I is volunteering their time. We technically are too, but they have chosen to help us out and work on the magazine because that was basically what we wanted. We wanted an outlet for creatives. We're not trying to create jobs for people. We're trying to create opportunities. So if you're an artist, but you have a random job that is not at all in the art field, you're able to work with us and put something beautiful, more beautiful than what else is in Charlotte, and we're going to listen to you and we're going to show off your work. And so basically all of our advertising dollars go to creating this beautiful publication, not to paying people, because it's not about the money. I understand people need to get paid and some people have their feelings about that, but if that's how they feel, then they've missed the whole point of the magazine.
So as a creative director, what do you do for the magazine?
What don't I do? I actually do the entire planning of what's going to go into it. I handle all of the photo shoots. I handle a lot of scheduling, the interviews, receiving assets from everyone. I don't use an intern or anything. I do all of that. So then I also do the layout for everything. Pretty much what you see is the stuff that I've done. Me and Nicole like bounce everything back and forth, and she writes most of the magazine, but I do all of the layouts, the gathering information, and all of that stuff.
The covers for Four Magazine are so striking. What is the process that you go through in choosing the cover?
Well, actually, we receive a lot of artist submissions, and I already have a little visual of kind of what I want. So I go through everything and I try to figure out what will really be wow enough, because we go through a couple before we decide on one. The very first issue was by a tattoo artist based in Brooklyn, and I had to ask her if I could invert it, and I wanted it to be gold foil. But then the printer told me the night before that I actually could not do that, so we used a metallic gold Pantone instead. But then the second issue, we used an artist from Australia, and then the third issue is an artist from Denmark. So I wanted them to all be very, very different. That's why it's not, they don't all have like just a masthead with the picture underneath, because I wanted it to feel like a book, like it's something different. They're not all the same.
How do you see the magazine evolving?
I would like it to still stay regional. I would like it to remain in the Southeast. And I will always include other artists, because I think that one of our big things is forcing content onto people. Somebody who may never look at something that's in our magazine is going to see it because they want to see what else is in there. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of, it works for everyone, because people who are only looking at it for the art will also see the interiors and just the other stories that we've included, and vice versa. It's in about 25 local boutiques, fashion stores, museums, just little independent shops. We wanted it to feel boutique-y, like it's part of the decor of the shop. It's not like a newsstand publication that's on the street or in doctor's offices, that sort of thing. We actually have a list of everywhere on our website, and you can actually order it online too. I am actually hoping that I will sort of leave the graphic design field itself and get more into focusing on publication design, which is still graphic design, but it's different. It's its own little thing. And focusing back on writing and painting and just being more like a creative, because I'm kind of at that crossroads that most artists come to when they're like, okay, I can either do a 9-to-5 for the paycheck, or, which I don't think that's selling out for everybody, but just for me, it's like I feel myself like deteriorating when I'm working in an office job. And so I would like to just be more freelance, but more about art also, and just be happy.
I turn it down a little bit.
In Charlotte, because there's just not.
We're definitely not going to use that.
Okay, sorry. I'm like...